Khiva, an ancient city in Uzbekistan, is one of the most well-preserved and historically significant cities in Central Asia. It lies in the Khwarezm region and has a rich history that spans over 2,500 years. The city's origins are steeped in legend, with some saying it was founded by Shem, the son of Noah. Historically, Khiva was a major trading post on the Silk Road, playing a crucial role in the exchange of goods, culture, and ideas between the East and the West. Over the centuries, Khiva has been influenced by various dynasties and empires, including the Persian Empire, the Arabs, and the Mongols. It became a prominent center of Islamic culture and learning, which is evident in its numerous madrasas, mosques, and mausoleums. In the 19th century, Khiva became the capital of the Khiva Khanate, a position it held until it became a part of the Soviet Union in the early 20th century. Today, Khiva is a part of independent Uzbekistan and a major tourist attraction. Khiva is divided into two main parts, the inner city and the outer city. The fortified inner city of Khiva covers an area of about 26 hectares. It is surrounded by brick walls, which are up to 10 meters high and 6 meters thick. This part is home to over 50 historic monuments and 250 old houses, making it a living museum. Some of the most significant sites of the inner city include Kolta Minor Minaret, Islam Khoja Madrasa, Muhammad Rahim Khan Madrasa, Allah Kuli Khan Madrasa, Jumeh Mosque, Pahlavan Mahmud Mausoleum, Taj Holy Palace, and Kania Ark or Old Fortress. The Kolta Minor Minaret is one of Khiva's most striking landmarks, renowned for its stunning turquoise tiles and unique design. With a base diameter of approximately 17 meters, this 19th century minaret was ambitiously intended to be the tallest in the Islamic world. However, construction was halted at a height of 29 meters, leaving it unfinished. Despite this, its broad base and vibrant decoration make it an iconic and instantly recognizable feature of Khiva's skyline. The minaret's abrupt truncation adds an air of mystery and intrigue, inviting visitors to imagine what it might have looked like had it been completed as originally envisioned. The Islam Khoja Minaret and Madrasa complex, constructed in the early 20th century, is a testament to Khiva's architectural brilliance and religious devotion. The madrasa covers about 1,250 square meters and served as an important center of Islamic education. Adjacent to the madrasa, the minaret stands at 57 meters, making it the tallest structure in Khiva and a prominent feature of the city's skyline. Its slender, tapering design and intricate tilework exemplify the region's rich artistic heritage. The combination of educational and religious functions within this complex highlights the integral role of Islam in the social and cultural fabric of Khiva. The Muhammad Rahim Khan Madrasa, constructed in the 19th century, is one of Khiva's most impressive educational institutions. Covering an estimated floor area of 3,000 square meters, this madrasa was named after Muhammad Rahim Khan II, a prominent ruler of Khiva known for his contributions to the cultural and intellectual life of the city. The madrasa features a grand facade adorned with intricate tilework and a large courtyard surrounded by lecture rooms and dormitories for students. It played a pivotal role in the religious and secular education of the region's youth, fostering a rich environment for learning and scholarly activity. The architecture of the madrasa, with its elegant arches and detailed decorations, stands as a testament to the architectural and cultural achievements of Khiva during the 19th century. The Allah Kuli Khan Madrasa and Charavansary complex dating back to the 19th century exemplifies Khiva's role as a bustling hub of trade and learning along the Silk Road. Covering a combined area of around 3,000 square meters, the madrasa provided Islamic education while the caravansary accommodated traders and travelers. The complex's architecture reflects the practical needs of commerce and the spiritual pursuits of education. The caravansary's spacious courtyards and the madrasa's classrooms highlight the interplay between economic activity and scholarly endeavors in Khiva. The Jumeh Mosque is a central and historical place of worship in Khiva, renowned for its unique architectural features. Covering an area of around 5,000 square meters, the mosque is particularly famous for its 213 wooden pillars, some of which date back to the 10th century. Reconstructed in the 18th century, the mosque creates a serene and contemplative atmosphere, reflecting its role as communal gathering place for prayers. Additionally, the Jumeh Mosque is complemented by a striking minaret standing at approximately 33 meters. This minaret, although not as tall as others in Khiva, stands out with its distinctive design and offers panoramic views of the city. The combination of ancient wooden columns and the minaret highlights the mosque's blend of architectural innovation and historical significance, making it a vital part of Khiva's cultural and religious landscape. The Turquoise Mausoleum is a revered site dedicated to Khiva's wrestler and poet Pahlavan Mahmud. Though relatively small in floor area, the tomb holds great cultural and spiritual significance. Dating back to the 14th century, with later additions, it serves as a pilgrimage site for many visitors. The mausoleum's exquisite tilework and serene atmosphere make it a place of reflection and reverence. Taj Holy Palace, built in the 19th century, is one of Khiva's most opulent and architecturally significant structures. Encompassing an area of about 8,000 square meters, the palace is renowned for its luxurious courtyards, elaborate harem, and impressive throne room. The intricate tile work, wood carvings, and frescoes that adorn the palace's interiors reflect the high artistic standards and craftsmanship of the era. Taj Holy Palace was designed to be both a residence and a place of governance, embodying the power and sophistication of Khiva's rulers. The palace's grandeur and meticulous detail make it a highlight for visitors exploring Khiva's historical sites. The Konya Arch served as the royal residence and administrative center for Khiva's khans. Spanning an area of about 20,000 square meters, this 17th century fortress is a microcosm of Khiva's political and cultural life. Within its walls, visitors can explore a variety of buildings, including a mosque, harem, mint, and stables. The Konya Arch's strategic location and imposing architecture underscore its significance as a symbol of power and governance. The fortress makes a tangible connection to the past with its well-preserved structures, providing a fascinating glimpse into the daily lives of Khiva's rulers. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this episode. Let me know your opinion in the comments section. And if you would like, please subscribe to my channel and wait for new videos.